29% of you guys voted for this, so here we are in 2009, when Stephen Hawking held a party for time travelers. But here's the twist. He sent out the invites a year later. And guess what? No one showed up. Travel into the past is probably impossible, but travel to the future? Now that's something we can work on. The easiest and most practical way to get to the far future is to go really, really fast. According to special relativity, when you travel at speeds approaching the speed of light, time slows down for you relative to the outside world. And this is not just a thought experiment, it has been measured. Two atomic clocks, one for in a jet aircraft and the other stationary on Earth. You will find that the flying clock ticks slower because of its speed. Gravity. Yep, the next method is also inspired by Einstein. According to his theory of general relativity, the stronger the gravity you feel, the slower time moves. I hope you guys remember Interstellar and that meme. For example, as you get closer to the center of Earth, the strength of gravity increases. Time runs slower at your feet than at your head. Your head ages faster than your feet, unless you spend most of your time hanging upside down, like bats. But we want to travel to the future, so all we need is a region of extreme strong gravity, such as, you guessed it right, black hole. The closer you get to the event horizon, the slower time moves. Is it risky? Yes, cross the boundary and you can never escape. Perception. Another way to travel to the future is maybe to slow down your perception of time. By slowing down or stopping your bodily processes and then restarting them later. I know. It's not the usual kind of time travel you were expecting, but it is time travel nonetheless. Look at bacterial spores. They can live for millions of years in a state of suspended animation until the right conditions of temperature, moisture, food kickstart their metabolism again. Can humans ever do the same? Maybe. But wormholes. Yeah. Now we are moving towards some exciting stuff. General relativity allows for the possibility for shortcuts through space-time, known as wormholes, which might be able to bridge different points in space and time. There is a possibility that wormholes are constantly popping in and out of existence at the quantum scale, far smaller than atoms. It's not a fact, it's something physicists believe in. The trick would be to capture one and inflate it to human scales, a feat that would require a huge amount of energy, but which might just be possible in theory. The problem is that no one knows how to build a wormhole, or once you have built it, how to keep it from collapsing. Keeping wormholes open requires a form of negative energies. Nobody knows how to make negative energies. Another idea is to use rotating cylinder of light to twist space-time. An infinitely long, super dense spinning cylinder which would also curve space-time enough to create a time loop. The problem, of course, is how do you build something that's infinite in size? It's probably the worst in terms of practicality, so I wouldn't even bother about it. The easiest way to travel in time is to do nothing. Yep, more than 3 minutes have passed since the start of this video. You already are in future, but so is everyone else, and that's no fun. So before you go on building rotating cylinders and stuff, share this video. Let others try it too. Maybe tell one of your least favorite friends to build an infinite rotating cylinder. I know most of you have already left. So those of you still here, here's a potato.